we have got, do we change the names?
We got Fire and Wind.
Yep. You change the names?
Yep.
Nice.
Names right. Are changed. Fire is blue, wind is red. Yeah.
Definitely. Messed it up. It's all right. It's so hard when the colors don't match.
This one's definitely.
There we go.
You want to switch the game
view? Yeah, so we're going to change over to game view. All right. Hopefully everybody thinks this stream has improved from last week. It's not. We're not filming on a potato. So
that's the trick, really.
All right. So let's get accustomed to some of the names here we're looking at and take a look at the builds we're dealing with. So again, we're seeing on the offense or on the defensive side. I'm sorry. We've got our Rhine set up there. We've got our Ana. Ninja's got our DPS, and they're running a Mercy. Looks like Mercy Ana for the healing. We got a Zarya. And then on the other side there, we got on the offensive side, we got an Ana. I always think that's a good choice. And a Lucio, which again, I prefer over Mercy on this map when you're playing on the offensive going forward. So we'll see what we got here.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, these are, again, pretty basic teams there. Dan was taking us out with the Bastion. That's what worked on the last one. He was subbing for the other teams. He's back again to, on his original team trying to make something happen.
Mm-hmm.
All right, let's see what we got here. So again, these teams are holding to the top. We noticed in the last match, they didn't retreat back to the front early enough, and that really cost them, both teams. We're gonna see if this team's learned from it.
Well, I wanna see if they try and hold this corner choke point, or whatever we're gonna call this elbow point here, because they really just kind of mowed through last game. So all right, again, let's see. Well, the cart's turning. They're going right through here.
They're lining up.
They're coordinated, though. Fire is coordinated here.
Much better moves there. You notice now they're holding onto that point and it's getting real hard for them to push
through. Wind is getting spread apart, slowly getting spread apart. Zarya building that ult, being protective, maybe a little too aggressive. Maybe not, she's still doing all right.
Free Straws drops his shield, kind of gives him an opportunity to push through here.
Charge shield's down, it's cracked. They've got full power Zarya there too, is another thing to note.
Irritable, saving up that res to get it up. Has an opportunity here. If he can get this res up, he can really keep their team alive. Here he goes. He's got to stay up, though. He's looking at 96%.
Yep.
Nobody to heal, though. He could also
nobody's
do
there. Get out of there. Get out of there. Is it your table or irritable?
I'm going with irritable.
Irritable sounds better.
Pops his hop, and there we go. Tries to make something happen. There it is.
There we go. Got Roadhog, maybe? No, nothing?
Good sleep there by Law. Coming around, keeping people up. Good play. Good plays by Ninja there. Got our ult ready to go. We're going to see if he's able to do anything here. They're holding on tight. Fire's really trying to make something happen.
Big ult.
I don't know if they've got anything to cover with
anyone,
this right
there's
now.
No damage coming in. Where's the damage coming? Oh my gosh.
Fire pops her ult real early.
Wow, that would have been a good
team
move if they did that. Yeah, big team win. I was looking at the team chat there. You're the bull.
That would work, though.
Oh, there's Kaiway Simpa.
All right, right on, right on.
Right on.
All right, got our teams pushing through here.
All right.
Good defense here by Fire. And if you remember, our Fire team went 3-0 last.
They did last
time.
Week.
Is that right?
Yeah.
So there are.
Fire.
Is that right?
Fire had no opposition last week. They swept it. So this may be a big upset for Fire considering they're on a roll.
Here we go. Look at our win team. We haven't been watching them too much.
Yeah.
We've got our Zarya all building up. Hopefully they're going to be able to make something else happen here. That
well, Wind is, they're leveraging, so as opposed to the Bastion build, it appears to me as though they're really leveraging the shield, this three tank build that they have. Am I saying that right? Yeah.
Yeah.
But then now they lost their main heal, so it's going to be a second here before they start getting heals back. So Ana's holding them strong. Mortius Mort in the back there holding him up.
Right, shield breaks. They got an opportunity to do something. If you can get a good ult here, Dan really shredding him apart here. Unbelievably good play there. Starting to push through. We've still got this Zarya ult. I think they're going to be able to push through this easily here.
Yeah.
Fire's kind of collapsing.
I really think, I'm thinking that Wind is going to just, I think they're very strong going into this. They're very collective, and the fact that they were able to not.
Particle beam down, particle shields, needs to get down.
Oh,
Swaggin
there
is,
we go.
It down. just holding this ult. He's waiting. There we go. He sees that Mercy. That's what he wants. That's his target.
He's going straight down. Oh, yeah.
Making it happen. Ooh! Gets
big Rhyne ult.
But you know what? They cleared this point. That's big. Yep. Really good ult there by Howl. Keeping him
nice
up.
Nice work.
Still waiting for this Zarya to make something happen. She's not pulling it, but she's holding it. Wind just continuing to push there. Dan up top, getting some work done. You'll notice they got this little split here. You know, Dan's up there, raining death from above. Well, you've got a really tank-heavy team on the bottom.
Yeah.
Just pushing through, and Dan can retreat easily. They don't have
a way to easily get out of the way, and if they go and go after Dan, they open up that bottom.
Here comes that ult.
Real big.
There it is.
Oh, there we go. Are they going to do some damage? Going to do some damage? Clean house?
Hands up there.
Wow. Dan just helped clean up with Zarya finally. That was well worth it.
And I think that's it. We're going to see team win, push it through. And
it's
again,
a very fast push through.
Very unexpected, probably, for the fire team. Really good play. Alright.
Wow.
We got some time left. Switching sides. I think we're in good shape here. We're going to see the side switch here. You know, sometimes I wonder with the teams that go from like that 3-0 sweep, I wonder if they're just overconfident in their abilities to a certain extent. To where maybe
they
feel
we
like,
don't have to work on any different builds, we don't have to address any, you know, any threats right away. It'll come through, it'll work itself through. I think we've all experienced that kind of burnout when we play long periods of competitive and you go on a long win streak. That happens to me.
Usually happens on my long losing streaks, but
that
I guess
happened
also
to me last night. That's why I look a little sleepy.
During our long win streaks, you know, it's easy to get, you know, lethargic with your wins and not give it at all. And I think Wind, you know, coming into this, they got a little something to prove. So we'll see what they can do. Try not to get
yourselves killed out there. All right, here we go. So do we have any big significant changes? I see a Zarya coming up there for fire.
Ready to move.
Again, though, Wind looks like they are doing that three tank build there, keeping it heavy that way.
You know, I noticed, you know, Ninja's been playing a lot of hit scan. They actually lost their hit scan on Team Fire here, which is okay because you're not really looking at anything that really requires a hit scan for the other team. They don't have a Pharah, so they can afford to do this. Problem, though, is Ninja's quickly going to realize that they've got an Ana, they've got a Soldier. It's going to be really hard to do work here as Pharah, but we've seen it before. We'll see what he can pull off.
Yeah. I don't know. I feel like a Pharah would be really effective here. I'm concerned, though. I would want a Soldier here. Let's see.
Yeah. You got Freestraws coming in, leading the charge.
Leading in. Is the shield working? Good toss up there. I like that. I like when Rhynes do that. Wow. Took out Dan right away.
We're
going to
see, you know, could have saved that concussive shot right there. That's a real common thing.
Yes. There we go. Nice. Nice. That is a great use of that concussive shot. Broke him up.
Got Freestraws cleaner him up. Just right down there, into the meat grinder down there.
Yeah.
Drop in.
Wow.
You got Freestraws just swinging like a madman.
Freestraws swinging freely.
Team Fire just gonna walk their way right through.
Yeah. Wow. Team Fire. They must have had some locker room talk before they started this here to amp them up because this is a quick turnaround. But look at the way Wind is positioning themselves, lumping behind Rhyne, using that to their advantage. They're like, we need to stay together.
Wow. That's going to be tough.
Took out the shield. That was,
Ooh. Jeez.
Ooh. That is almost a team wipe there. That is really something.
Team Wind really came back strong there.
Wind said no.
My ultimate is ready.
This is times like I want some audio drops in here.
That'll be the improvement to the stream.
Yeah, that'll be next we'll have audio drop. Alright, here we go.
This is gonna be big. We're gonna see.
Well, they're keeping fire at the choke despite the payload not even being there. I mean, that's pretty impressive. Oh, Pharah up over top. That Rhyne better watch. Nira better watch the top there.
I think they're really focusing. Get Freestraw's shield broken.
Yep.
And then all right through it. You know, that would be a big play there.
It would be great. Look, it's just timing it. near Azura is just, yep.
He's getting ooped in there.
Yep. Oh, wow. Big ult. Big ult. What's going to happen? Nope. See that Mercy. The Mercy stayed out of it.
That's his ult.
Wow.
Not a lot of people in it, though.
No, no, no. Still caused a good amount of chaos, though, so that was effective.
Irritable keeping him up.
Wow, damn.
Jesus. Falling right now. Win, not able to keep it together. And we're going to have fire.
Wow.
Progressing through just like they did before.
We got Loth in there. Doing the best he can with that healing.
Good. The first point.
Wow.
Good play by
Team
Fire.
That's a good turnaround. Yeah, Fire did a nice recovery. You would have thought other teams would have broken there.
Absolutely. And, you know, you look at, there's a reason Fire went 3-0 last time, and I think we're starting to see it right here. Once they get dialed in, can really become an unstoppable train.
Yeah.
You got great heals, great teamwork, they're patient. It's going to pay off here in the long run.
Patience is the key word I'm getting out of here.
Oh, yeah. Too often we see teams start to panic and just throw themselves at it. You gotta trust your team. Build it up. Ooh, big opening there. Misses the same dart.
Oh, yeah. That's okay.
But you
just gotta wait for the timeline. The nade throw. Oh, no. That was good. That was good.
They're up top. Again, we're looking at this opportunity. Take the high ground. Way easier to shoot. Way easier to defend. Then they just drop on top and they can really shred them if it's coordinated. And now feeding that Zarya a little bit. Three straws, tight spot, tries to make something happen, gets bumped off. No good. You got Team Win holding strong here.
Oh, another Zarya ult drops down in there, answered with a Lucio ult. The pain.
It's not going to be enough. They're just going to walk right up here.
I feel better.
Yeah.
I'm going to
live. Wow.
Three straws trying to get on there, but they're not going to be able to do much here.
I love those Rhine throws. I'm sorry. Even if they don't kill him, I still love them. Zarya, activate.
Let's see. Right, so they're going to hold back here a little bit, hopefully. Going to see what they can do. Fire's going to regroup.
Look at him. Fire. They're probably talking right now, getting that team back up.
Well, the best part about these in-person tournaments, we can look over and say, are they talking?
I can hear chatter. I can chatter.
Oh, yeah. We got a big sleep on the Rhine up there, but not able to execute. We're gonna see what Free Straws can do. The only downside about having your ball, we dropped them right now, but when the Rhine's up there, that ult's just free range. Who's gonna win this shield battle? That's a big question here. Free Straws hungry for his ult. It's starting to drop. But so is his shield. Could be a big moment.
Oh, nice!
Takes it out. Unbelievably good play.
Wow.
He's got an opportunity here. They can break that.
No.
Show them. Quick res up irritable.
I didn't even check Mercy's res. There we go.
Boom, boom, right there. Right there. Doesn't make it.
No, doesn't
happen.
Do it. Is he gonna do? Nope. Every time I see that shield go down, I'm thinking he's here. We go. Here we go. Here we go. Come on.
No. Unbelievable block by Narazini.
Wow.
That means that ult is down, and they wasted a lot of time trying to make something happen.
Yeah, that is a lot of time down in the clock
here,
there.
But lost. Rez is down.
You know what? Say what you will, but the momentum of the payload is still going forward. Oh, no, never mind. Contested. Spoke too soon.
No, absolutely.
Like still,
you agree. They're still moving it forward. That's kind of all that matters. But another Reinald
comes down
here. It's going to be hard, but
wish we had seen that.
We can pop this all right there, and he does.
There we go, yeah.
Rexxaw, look at that. Get something right here.
Rexxaw gets shut down again. But look at the damage Ana just did. Wow.
Keep it up. Really good play by Loth. He's going to keep this going.
Loth is doing some really good work here as Ana.
We've seen some really good Ana play. They've managed to pick this up together. They were struggling on this point.
Fire is coming together here.
Yep.
They managed here to they are. It. They're coming back. Look at that. Yep. And that's a cap. Wow. Nice work.
About a minute slower than our win team.
Mm-hmm.
But they're making it happen.
Yeah.
Again, though, you know, on these sort of payload-y style maps, all you need is that minute, right, to cap, to get any sort of time, and you can really make a good comeback on maps like this in overtime. Irritable back with the res. The offensive reses can be touch and go, but here we go. We saw that grenade.
Oh, here it goes again. What are they going to do? They're going to damage it out. Dan is coming in to clean house.
Sniped it. We missed that.
Wow.
Missed it
like
we
did. Oh. That's how good it was.
But he's still not able to make it happen. They're able to pick this up. A lot of people dropping here. Ninja. Being a ninja.
Yep. looks like the lone representative on fire there for a little bit, that's for sure. But keeping that payload is now stalled. Here we go.
Happen, but
is he going to go after Dan? Is he going to go? Okay, got rid of the Brian. Yep, great getting rid of their DPS. Wow. Nice work. Good use of that alt fire, too.
You'll notice the support from that Zarya bubbles constantly to keep them up.
Yes.
Really good. Right now, team
building.
Team Wynn's got to be thinking, how do we just delay this a little bit, sneak out a little time? But we've ran it back right now, so we're going into OT.
We got ourselves a game. Wow.
Exciting game still. Continues to.
Yeah. I have to say, compared to what could have happened in that match, I'd say that was pretty good.
No, absolutely. I think sometimes you lose that first point, you kind of lose your spirit. But again, both teams able to really keep it together, show why they're here, why they're so good. So we're going to have an opportunity to see what else is coming up, and should be exciting. You only see half my face, though. That's the problem. Yeah.
Well,
got to keep that preview up.
We're working on that, yeah.
You don't know where I'm at.
Well, the preview, I don't know if it's using more horsepower or not.
All right. All right. Let's see what we got here. Back to game. Ninja's switching over to McCree. We got Dan. Dare he do a Bastion?
He dare. There we go. Should I move that emblem back to the left? I don't know.
What is our chat thing?
Yeah, what's our chat thing of the emblem? I just moved it to the middle when it gets there.
I kind of like the middle.
Kind of leave some sort of watermark on it. All right, here we go.
Dan, being sneaky.
Fire's coming out.
So they notice they've got ourselves a Bastion up there. We're going to see how this is able to go. All right. Dan really trying to make some stuff happen there, but we've got a Roadhog behind him, but Rexxaw is undefended. He's going to be an easy pickoff, and they're just going to be able to reclaim that top point again. Dan trying to get some kills there. He's really dangerous position,
yeah,
but it's working.
That. Wow, it's right over top. Is he going to get the Mercy? No.
No, good defense there.
Wow.
They're able to hold right here under the bridge. This is such a hard spot to hold. If you notice, they got 10 seconds left right now on this point.
They're holding on. He's got his ult here ready to pop too. So when it comes to that moment of desperation, we got Loth. No, Loth didn't even avoid.
Totally walking through them. Jeez. Pops his ult, keeps himself
there
up.
There he goes, yep. Clear him off.
That's it. Really good play there. Really strong Bastion. That really kind of just shut him down, didn't it? They didn't stand a chance. We're going to see if they can do better than that. I'd be surprised if they weren't able to. It's possible, but they got 3 minutes to get just past the arch.
Yeah. That's a lot of time to move a very short distance. Dive comp?
Oh, yeah. Dive comp. It's the only way at this point. Let's see. They're sticking to what they knew. They were fired up these heroes quick.
Yeah.
Ninja's thinking, I can beat Dan.
Yeah, look at that. There can only be one true Bastion, right?
So this is the first time that Fire's been looking at a potential loss, right? Am I reading this correctly? Yeah.
Yeah, this is going to be a huge, huge deal.
Will definitely shake up our standings, which is I think is what I'm very interested to see. Who's going to walk out of these games in the lead? Oh, we've got Dan trying to be an offensive Bastion.
Oh,
so maybe a little cheese on there. But also maybe not. We'll see what he's able to do.
Yeah, let's see what they're thinking. Yeah, but if you think about it, he was an offensive Bastion on this map when he was subbing on the last game.
That's true. So he knows it could work. But, you know, Bastion v. Bastion, you're looking at shield battles. But, you know, SJ Ripper as the D.Va is really going to be a big determiner there because he's going to suck up so many Bastion shots. He's got to activate that. There it is.
Yeah, here
we go. He's
going to
turn that on. Shields up.
Shreds that shield.
Nobody's dropping, but you're going to notice, Ninja's not able to reclaim it. And they're just going to keep
there,
on
there
walking.
There it is. Only one Bastion should be there. He's asleep.
He snoozes.
He's taking a nap on the job.
Damn, trying to make... They're holding on. They're holding on tight, but, you know, it's going to be hard.
Oh,
yep.
Oh, wow.
Just goes through right there. Really good play there. Punched
it
through.
Went straight in.
It's hard to hold all the way up there. They did a really good defense, so... So it's Team Fire's first loss as Wind takes it. Play of the game is probably going to Dan, I'll be honest. I have a very strong feeling.
Let's see. Yep.
It's going to be this Bastion play.
Wow.
Let's see, I think I remember this. No, this was not at all what I was expecting.
Yeah, this was a sleepy play.
Man, he was like mowing him down the last time.
I mean, okay, it's the end of the game, but...